You're watching CN2 News, your number one source for award-winning hometown coverage.
A hero's final goodbye, celebrating the life of 37-year-old York County Sheriff's Deputy Detective Michael Doty.
The support from cities throughout North and South Carolina and beyond, truly remarkable. Today, marking the final chapter in a very emotional week for everyone here in York County and especially the law enforcement community.
Thanks for watching CN2 News. Hello, I'm Laura Bree Monday.
Good evening, I'm Lucas McFadden. He was a son, a brother, and a friend.
A person who lived life and laughed and loved. And all of that and more described during a beautiful ceremony that lasted nearly 2 hours at a Charlotte church, followed by an enormously long motorcade that brought him back home.
Detective Michael Doty was one of four officers shot in York County last week after responding to a domestic call. The other wounded officers, K-9 handler Sergeant Randy Clinton, Sergeant Buddy Brown, and York Police Sergeant Kyle Cummings all faced and will continue to face surgeries, but they all will survive, always keeping Detective Doty in their hearts.
His service today taking place at Calvary Church in Charlotte to accommodate the large crowd. The church can sit 5,000 people, and it was full.
Deputies wearing the symbolic black band across their badges, and those bands have the number 809 written on them. That was Doty's call number. CN2's Catherine Andrioli was there taking us inside this very emotional service.
An outpouring of support for York County Sheriff's Detective Mike Doty. Family, friends, and colleagues gathering at Calvary Church Monday.
You know, there's so much to say about Mike. He was obviously special and loved. Everybody loved Mike.
When life changes, you can always depend on Mike.
Hundreds of law enforcement members honoring Doty, including the three officers who were shot and injured last week. They're now beginning their journey to recovery, and we're not going to miss the opportunity to honor their brother. York County Sheriff Kevin Tolson giving testimony during the celebration of Doty's life, speaking about his passion for helping those around him.
If you were Mike's friend, Mike would tell you the truth. No matter what it was, it might hurt your feelings, but later on you go, you know what? He's right.
Doty's twin brother, a fellow law enforcement officer at the York County Sheriff's Office, also speaking on his brother's behalf. He says his legacy will be one of bringing a community together.
Let it bring you right there with us as we were with Mike in his last moments.
It's an opportunity for us to readdress ourselves to making a positive impact, not only in our families, but in our communities, because that's what Mike tried to do.
Detective Doty began his journey in law enforcement in 2006. He was an investigator with the York County Multi-Jurisdictional Drug Enforcement Unit. He was also the officer Narcan program coordinator for the Sheriff's Office and was a member of SWAT. He was an associate advisor for the York County Explorer program, where he mentored children who wanted to get into law enforcement. Family members say Doty's legacy will be one that forever changes the department and the lives of those he touched.
We want to thank each and every individual that's sharing and rejoicing in Mike's impact on his family, his friends, and his community.
In hundreds of law enforcement agencies following that processional to lay Detective Mike Doty to rest, it really was a celebration of his life, his family mentioning what a passion he had for his job at the York County Sheriff's Office. They also mentioned how he's an organ donor, and they hope he can help save lives. In Charlotte, Catherine Andrioli, CN2 News.
All right, Catherine, thank you.
And being an organ donor just speaks to the character of Detective Doty. New York County Sheriff Kevin Tolson drove Doty's car to the funeral today, making quite a joke about that at the service.
He says that was actually Doty's fourth car, and the sheriff said he's not sure who had more wrecks, Dale Earnhardt or Doty. Ironically, Earnhardt's funeral was also at Calvary Church. Those who knew Doty said that he would want to find them laughing somehow on this difficult day.
Well, following the celebration of life service there in Charlotte, Doty's body made the more than 20-mile journey to his final resting place at Forest Hill Cemetery there on Old York Road here in Rock Hill.
CN2's Renee O'Neill joining us outside the cemetery where thousands followed to pay their respect.
Yes, earlier it was quite the scene to see so many people coming here to honor Detective Doty. Now, the cemetery is quiet now where he was laid to rest, but it was quite the journey to get here. hundreds of law enforcement officers and more traveled to Charlotte for Detective Doty's funeral. Afterwards, they made the journey with Doty's body from Calvary Church to right here off Old York Road at Forest Hills Cemetery. Many roads were shut off for part of the day as the procession made its way to Doty's final resting place. At the graveside burial, there was a horse-drawn carriage that carried Doty's casket by the North Carolina Troopers Association and Highway Patrol Caisson Unit.
We're here to comfort and support the lost life of a loved one, a fellow brother. It's the least that we can do from North Carolina.
Many people, young and old, took the time to pay their respects to a hero.
To show respect and just thank you for the service that he's done.
It's just really important that we show our children and the community that we support our police.
Now, state leaders tell me that the U.S. flag that was draped over Doty's casket was actually flying over the state capitol building in Columbia the night that Doty passed away. That flag and our state flag were both given to Doty's family in memory of him. Now, our Senator Wes Clymer also adding that Doty and the three other officers who were shot that night were heroes long before that horrific ambush. He says anyone who wears the badge and goes out to defend and protect our community are heroes. For now, we're in Rock Hill. Renee O'Neill, CN2 News.
So true, Renee. Also at the burial service, there was a 21-gun salute and dispatch called Doty's last and final call. Police departments from all over the state and even the country attending. We saw police officers from as far as New York City.
Well, SLED officials also telling us that the suspect, Christian McCall, who police say shot all four officers, is still at CMC in Charlotte. We still do not know much about his condition. Our news partner, WBTV, telling us from a FOIA request it's learned from SLED, McCall was in the Army from 91 to 1994 as a petroleum vehicle operator. He had several awards to his name, including some involving being a sharpshooter with an auto rifle. In Tuesday's newscast, we will be speaking with a pastor who knew McCall and said he never would have imagined he would have done something like this.
The celebration of life for Detective Michael Doty has lasted for a full week, basically. Those who knew him and those who didn't want to come together with their fellow neighbors, sharing stories, prayers, and wishes for his family and all those in law enforcement. Sunday, no different. CN2's Indira Esquiva with York County Voices coming together.
An armed man looking to do harm was roaming the streets in York County. And Sergeant Mike Doty and Sergeant Buddy Brown, Sergeant Randy Clinton, and Sergeant Kyle Cummings met that man to protect me.
They took the call into the darkness, into the uncertainty, into the chaos, fearlessly, courageously, trying to help people.
We celebrate the life of Detective Mike Doty.
The support has been overwhelming and humbling. We've gotten calls from all over the United States from people we've never even met, never heard of, probably never will meet.
If you want to bring a community together, try and destroy it.
Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. We will mourn Detective Mike Doty, but he will not be forgotten.
During the vigil, speakers also touching on another important issue, domestic violence. Remember, that is what these brave men were responding to when they were shot. York Mayor Lee said his father was a police officer and domestic calls were always full of uncertainty. Anything could happen. The York County Sheriff's Office has had three officers die in the line of duty, according to the Officer Down memorial page.
Well, the community showing how they stand in solidarity with members of law enforcement. And a touching tribute, the Still Patriots Riding Club drove in a procession to Detective Doty's vigil outside of the Moss Justice Center in York. Around 20 motorcycles headed by a police escort made their way from the Rock Hill Airport. At the vigil, everyone got off their motorcycles to stand and pray, not just for Doty and his family, but for all first responders who put their lives on the line every day.
Who else is going to get up, put a badge on, and become the walking target or moving target just because people think they can get away with it. Nobody's going to do nothing to them. We're here to say we're going to do something about it. We're going to back the blue. We're going to be there. If they need help and we're nearby, we're going to respond. We're going to help.
The Steel Patriots telling us they are planning a much bigger ceremony to honor law enforcement in March. For now, though, they say they just want to let them know that they appreciate their sacrifices.
Our community will honor another fallen hero this week, a fallen soldier also being remembered in York County. The Fort Mill High School wrestling team will be remembering one of its own, former wrestler Javion Sullivan. The match is this Tuesday night, and it is their home game. Specialist Sullivan was a U.S. soldier who was killed earlier this month in the fight against ISIS in Iraq. The 24-year-old leaves behind a wife and a 3-year-old daughter. Well, here's our latest Arrowpoint Federal Credit Union picture of the day, another moving tribute for Detective Michael Doty. The city of Rock Hill turning its water tower blue to honor and celebrate his life. We'll continue our coverage of our fallen hero after this.
Welcome back to CN2 News.
As our community continues to heal following the death of York County Sheriff's Detective Michael Doty's death, we are still seeing a lot of love from others throughout South Carolina and beyond.
Yeah, many law enforcement officers volunteering their time here in York County so deputies can attend Doty's funeral this Monday.
The New York Yankees, get this, even sent a flower arrangement to the Moss Justice Center where there is a memorial for Doty.
Well, two women are getting creative, doing their part to remember and honor those law enforcement officers who put their lives on the line every day. CN2's Alexandria Savage with their story tonight.
Two moms here in York decided to take a break from preparing for their store's grand opening in order to honor a hero past, Detective Michael Doty, one print at a time.
November 1st, Sweet Tea opened its doors to the York community. Co-owners Amber Johnson and Jessica Cartwright, who were raised in the area, are passionate about their new neighbors. So when tragedy struck, they stepped up. With the help of Sheriff Kevin Tolson, these ladies designed a t-shirt to commemorate Detective Doty's ultimate sacrifice and honor his other three brothers in blue who were injured in last week's incident. 100% of the proceeds will go to the families of Detective Doty and the other members of the SWAT team that were injured. So far, their downtown shop has placed more than 600 orders coming from all over the nation.
My dad is a retired police officer. We have cousins and uncles and a long line that, you know, either they're retired or still in the field. So this is very special to us.
It's a huge sacrifice on their part, as well as their families, because they're letting them go out and make sure that we're okay.
In order to prepare for the large order coming in, Amber and Jessica are looking for volunteers to help them unpack, fold, and transport t-shirt orders Saturday. Both women say they are grateful for this support, but this is their duty to the community of York to make sure officers and their families are okay.
And Governor Henry McMaster is honoring Detective Doty and all of those injured in last week's incident by ordering all flags in the state to be flown at half mast, like the one here in front of the York Courthouse, to honor their sacrifice. In York, Alexandria Savage, CN2 News.
I would imagine quite special to see all those flags at half staff for the family.
Jessica and Amber say they are in need of food donations for all of the volunteers coming in to help this Saturday. If you would like to volunteer, they say that simply just message them on Facebook.
Also, no more shirts will be pre-ordered after this Saturday, so you have until then 5 p.m. to place your order. The official grand opening of Sweet Tea in York is actually this Saturday as well.
Well, tonight's CN270 forecast, expect rain overnight, but the high will return to the 60s with a cool down coming on Wednesday.
In tonight's CN2 digital dashboard, the U.S. Senate has reached a compromise to reopen the government after its shutdown of 2 days.
Congressman Ralph Norman, who represents us here in the 5th District, forfeited his pay during the course of this government shutdown. Norman says it's actually embarrassing that the shutdown happened in the first place.
And I sat in the chambers to hear the back and forth, and the public, Americans deserve better than this. That's why politics matters. Who we put in office matters. You've got to have straight-thinking people who do what's best for the country, not getting reelected and not trying to have a base that gets you votes illegally.
Now, this is just a temporary fix, as this bill will keep the government open until February the 8th. The debate, however, likely to continue.
All right, still to come here on CN2 News, our former school board member back in the headlines for being on the wrong side of the law.
Plus, later in CN2 Sports, why you have an extra reason to watch this year's Super Bowl. You're watching CN2 News.
A former Lancaster County school board member has been arrested for a third time on drug charges. Exactly 1 year ago, James Brooks was arrested, and now the Lancaster County Sheriff's Office says once again the 51-year-old is charged with possession of meth. He posted a $10,000 bond, but was actually released to the Rock Hill Police Department, where he was wanted on a warrant charging him with failure to return rental property. Well, the Children's Attention Home has named its interim executive director.
Emily Parrish, who is the current residential services director, will now serve as the interim executive director once that current director, Deborah Iden, retires February 2nd. The search for a permanent replacement is underway. Emily Parrish played a primary role in the home's recent accreditation accomplishment, and she also helped to launch its newest program that serves homeless young people.
Hello, I'm Veronica Muir with today's To Your Health. Joining us is Dr. Matthew Schwartz, orthopedic surgeon at Carolina Orthopedic Surgery Associates, to talk about rotator cuff surgery. Welcome, Dr. Schwartz.
Thank you.
What exactly is the rotator cuff and what does it do?
The rotator cuff is a group of four muscles, and basically it helps start the motion in the shoulder.
So what are some of the more common rotator cuff problems that you see in your practice?
Well, of course, most people are familiar with rotator cuff tears, the more serious of the problems. But rotator cuff syndrome is probably the most common problem I see and usually can be treated without surgery.
Well, that's great that you don't always need surgery if you have a rotator cuff issue. But when surgery is required, is it a long recovery process?
Yes, it's usually surprising to patients, but it can take 6 months or even up to a year to recover from that surgery.
Is there anything that patients can do to make it a less lengthy process?
Well, just follow my directions.
Okay, and let's talk a little bit about your surgical specialties before we go.
Mostly shoulder injuries, but of course shoulder reconstructive surgeries as well, which include shoulder replacement.
Okay, Dr. Schwartz, thank you so much for joining us today. Mm-hmm. You can contact Dr. Schwartz at Carolina Orthopedic Surgery Associates. I'm Veronica Muir, and this has been To Your Health.
To Your Health is brought to you by Carolina's healthcare system, Pineville. Email your questions for To Your Health to news@cn2.com.
Winthrop Hedman's basketball coach Pat Kelsey displaying his sandwich making skills at Subway for the Coaches vs. Cancer campaign. He is one of the coaches in the Charlotte area taking time out of his busy schedule to focus on a common cause, which is ending cancer. The Coaches vs. Cancer program is a collaboration between the American Cancer Society and the National Association of Basketball Coaches. This is Coach Kelsey's second year participating, and it's the 25th anniversary of the American Cancer Society Coaches vs. Cancer program.
As you know, cancer affects us all. One in every two male American citizens will deal with cancer sometime throughout their lifetime. One in three women. That is a scary statistic, and we have a fight on our hands, and we need you to help us. The coaches in this area and the NCAA level are really, really committed to fighting this battle, and we need your help as well. Thank you for everything you're doing to fight this terrible, terrible disease of cancer, and together we can beat it.
South Point Stallions alum and New England Patriots cornerback Stephon Gilmore is playing in his first ever Super Bowl, and he is the first Stallions alum to make it to the Super Bowl. He made a big play for the Patriots against the Jaguars on Sunday, swatting the ball away in the fourth. The New England Patriots will be taking on the Philadelphia Eagles in Super Bowl 52. And Northwestern alum Benjamin Watson is one of the three finalists for the Walter Payton NFL Man of the Year Award. The other finalists are J.J. Watts, a defensive end for the Houston Texans, and Greg Olsen, a tight end for the Carolina Panthers. These three have been picked as the finalists for this award because they leave a positive impact on their communities. The winner will be announced during the NFL Honors on February 3rd.
It is that time again for CN2 Athlete of the Week. Our Athlete of the Week is Zy Brown. Now, Zy made a huge buzzer beater in one of his games for York Middle School. So, Zy, I'm going to present you with this shirt for our Athlete of the Week.
Thank you.
You're welcome. The game was tied 41-41, and York Middle had the ball with 4 seconds left to play. Zy Brown gets the ball, takes the shot, and it goes in. York Middle wins the game. That shot is the first game winner Zai has hit in his basketball career. And a buzzer beater shot like the one Zai made is something the team will never forget. And it got the momentum going for the rest of the season.
It was just a team play because we got a big stop on defense. So it led to 4.6 seconds. So we was going to try to roll it to stop the time, but it didn't happen. They pressured. So we got the ball. We went down court, and I just shot. And then it was excited for the team. It was just that was a game plan, team shot.
I mean, he just made a great shot, and when it left his hands, I thought, man, this thing looks pretty good. And, you know, of course, it goes in, and it doesn't matter what level you play or coach. Those kind of shots are, you know, they're meaningful and something he'll never forget and his teammates and coaches will never forget.
An unforgettable moment for our Athlete of the Week, Zai Brown. That's your Monday Sports Report. I'm Danielle DeTomo.
All right, Danielle, thank you very much.
Special day for sure. Thanks for joining us, everyone. We'll see you back here tomorrow with a brand new newscast.
Good night.